Good morning.
Good morning.
Good to see all of you today. Well, we've had quite a variety of music, haven't we?
Yes.
Goodness me. That's one of the nice things about coming here. You get such a nice selection of music presented. Didn't always used to be that. Used to be very iffy, as a matter of fact. Wasn't even taken into account. I was playing. So, happiness? Happiness. Today we're approaching it from a perspective of it expresses action. So, how active are you with your happiness? See, that's really an indicator as to where you are in relationship to happiness. Your life, somewhere along the way, is going to dawn on you that it's a precious gift. Hopefully it'll be before your last gasp. And if not, don't worry about it, because you'll come back. I intend to spend as much of my remaining time in this incarnation as happy as I possibly can. And I'm realizing that my happiness really doesn't depend on you, but I can share happiness if you choose to be happy too. And if we choose to be happy together, we magnify it. Have you ever tried to be happy around someone who just refused?
Yes.
It took a lot of effort, didn't it?
Yes.
But, you know, sometimes that's a good thing, because then it goes to show you just how much energy, how much willingness, how much deliberation you're going to put into choosing to be happy. Sometimes what that results in is divorce. Who wants to be stuck with a sad sack? No, I mean, you can make all kinds of excuses that you want, but my encouragement is, if you're with someone that you love, then of course you're doing what you love. And if you're not, then you're not doing what you love. You can take that many different ways, but it still comes up to a realization. If you do what you love, then you're also involved in loving what you do. And if you're sharing time, spending time with someone else that you love, then your happiness is going to be magnified. It's going to be increased. You know, I have really met so many people who are afraid to be happy. They are operating under an assumption that if they get happy, then they're going to have it taken away from them. Do you get the insanity in this kind of logic? Really, it's like saying, I can't afford to be happy because it's going to be taken from me. Well, what if you got happy and found out that happiness cannot be taken from you? It is a personal experience. Someone else can do things that will affect you, so in that you cut your cost to realize, okay, happiness really is a matter of me balancing living in the present as well as my future. If I let regrets come into the picture, then I'm really, really staying bound to the past. And my chances for experiencing happiness and having that be a wonderful ongoing opportunity is reduced dramatically. So you have to get out of the past. Say goodbye to the past. The past has been good to you. It's brought you to where you are, but leave it be. That's much like saying with happiness too, I don't encourage you to get involved in somebody else's flow, because then you're missing your own flow so far as your happiness flow. Everybody knows that happiness is something that is a desired experience. But your circumstances, they aren't necessarily always going to be ideal to give you that guarantee that it's going to happen to you without effort. You're going to have to put some effort into it. That's what I was talking about so far as getting into somebody else's flow. Mind your own journey. Well, that's a nice way of saying mind your own business, you know. Especially when you find the third journey is very rocky. No? Somebody else's rockiness can really add the jitters to your happiness. It will test out your suspension, for sure. It will see how well you are really hung together and how well you're going to weather the storm, whereas in reality, it's just a better thing to mind your own journey. What are some of the things that can help you so far as happiness? Well, it's such a duh, but I even have to remind myself from time to time, and that's be grateful. Gratitude is an amazing door opener. It's also an energy that allows you to move from one set of awarenesses into another. Because if you let go of what was bringing you down and keeping you down, and you choose to put gratitude in its place, it then opens you up. It opens life up to where you can right then and there start experiencing happiness. I'm happy because I'm not feeling crummy like I was feeling crummy just before I decided to get grateful. It is that quick, it is that sure to work. And it will lead you to a place where, if you're paying attention, you can practice being happy. And practicing being happy is being happy.
Yes.
Really. Okay, maybe you can improve on your happiness skills. All of us mostly can. But if you open yourself up, you'll see, okay, gratitude can help me to come to a place to realizing I have things to be happy about. I have things to feel good about. I recently watched a movie that I've watched many times because I get a kick out of it. And in the movie, there is this character who is always, he portrays a priest. So this is just a movie, okay? So any of you who have real strong ties to Catholicism, it's just a movie. And, of course, priests in many different religions have a prayer for everything that happens. And sometimes they'll have to carry around a book, you know, just to make sure that they get a match. The right prayer for the right catastrophe, you know. But Eckhart Tolle is really simplified. Because he says, if the only prayer you ever say is thank you, that will suffice. So consider it now. We're talking about the simplicity of getting to a place where you're able to enjoy your life and find happiness being there, enjoying it with you. Say thank you. Just thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Not shut up, but thank you. Thank you. Okay. And this will help you because you'll get to that place of saying, all right, I may not always get what I want, but I know. I know I'll always get what I need. And as you can make this shift inside yourself to where you get away from just a want, selfish basis to a realization that this universe in which I live really is a favorable universe. It's giving me exactly what I need. If I can open up to that, then I can find my capacity for happiness increases. Because I'm not short-circuiting myself by demanding that I only get what I want. You ever feel stressed?
Mm-hmm. Yes.
It happens. I felt stressed this morning, so I had a drink and I made it here. I didn't tell you of what. Okay. Here's a shift. We're talking a lot about shifts here, aren't we?
Yes.
Okay. The day I shift from stressed to blessed is the day I open myself up to greater happiness. And I am truly blessed. I look back now and I see how many years I lived stressed, I lived unhappy. And I look at the changes that I have made. I look at the help that I have had, because certainly I have not done it by myself. I look at the input that you have had in it. And I say to you, thank you for all that you have done and made available. In being you, in your own unique way of choosing to relate to me through the ways that we have communicated and are communicating. And I say this to you because I'm really speaking of varying degrees and types of happiness that I live in my life. Because I'm not just a one-dimensional happy guy. I find that I experience happiness in a number of ways, and certainly you are one of those ways that I find to be valuable. So, I have with that a trust in life and a trust in the flow of life. And I have learned to shift my focus from what could go wrong to what could go right. I've learned to move away from expecting the worst to happen, to dismissing that as an erroneous mindset that really is a trap, and open myself up to the possibilities of what could my future be. And in that, I have moved away from fearful considerations to curious considerations of what could my future hold for me? What could it bring? What positives could it show itself? And that's looking at it as if it were all happening to me without the awakening realization that is happening through me. As I have grown in the continuing dawning that I am the creator of my life and it is always showing up whether I recognize it or not, I've grown even happier. Because I have found that I have less of a feeling that I can't trust life, a feeling of being less than, and in its place has grown this developing sense of I may not understand it all, but I am certainly starting to feel a lot more comfortable even with the amassing of unknowns that are showing up. And with that, another type of happiness comes to me and resides in me, and that is a contented happiness. Not this always bubbly expression of happiness, but a happiness in knowing that truly all is well. And that even though I don't understand it all, I have an abiding sense that it is good and will reveal itself to me and through me as I continue allowing myself to grow, to awaken. So this happiness thing that is a verb, expresses action, I'm really sharing with you a number of possibilities that the action can manifest itself. Get your attention to where you choose to be happier than you ever have been before. And it doesn't always mean waiting until, what is that called? Happy hour? But you may. It's all right. But here we are, and it's wow, it's way before happy hour. And look at how happy you're getting. Look at how happy you're feeling. You see, this is you choosing to open up to another state of being that is a part of your naturalness that you're awakening to where you allow yourself to be present with life and an attending ease, to where you feel happy just being. So thank you for allowing me to share this with you and to feel you sharing with me, for which I say to you, thank you, thank you, thank you.
Thank you.
For more information about the Metaphysical Church of Enlightenment or the Rodin Foundation, please go to our website at www.rodin.org. If you have been inspired by the revelations shared in these podcasts, please donate to the Rodin Foundation's ongoing efforts to help others help themselves at www.rodin.org/donate.